A Senate committee has recommended confirmation to the state Supreme Court for a nominee whose few detractors took issue with her sexual orientation as potential support for civil unions. Gina Mangieri reports.
Joe, family court judge Sabrina McKenna got the yes vote of even the most staunch anti-civil union senator, with supporters saying it's time to judge candidates by only their qualifications.
A packed committee room looked on as Judge Sabrina McKenna came up for round one of the Supreme Court confirmation process. The Judiciary Committee chairman asked those in opposition to speak first. One did.
She is an open homosexual and would be inclined to show legal favoritism in the contentious issues surrounding homosexuality in the state of Hawaii.
Two senators on the panel who oppose civil unions both back this nominee.
And I look at Lady Justice and I see Lady Justice with the blindfold. It was very unfortunate that other issues were brought into the discussion.
Senator Ihara?
Aye.
Senator Sloan?
Aye.
Out of hundreds of pages of testimony submitted, the majority was in favor. Most of the dozen or so writing in opposition criticized her with the same phrase, outspoken lesbian. Her supporters praised her for being open about it.
She can be a model to others who are serving in a closeted capacity, wherever they may serve. People of this caliber and this quality wait on lists and wait on lists until we have governors who have the courage to appoint them.
Emotional testimony came from the family of murder victim Sydney Klein, whose daughter was almost taken from her extended family by an absentee mainland father in a bitter custody battle. McKenna awarded custody to the aunt instead.
We miss Sydney. She was stolen from all of us, and we will never be the same. And then Kiara was almost stolen from us, too. Our family will forever be grateful for the rest of our lives for the decision that Judge McKenna made.
The rest of the testimony focused on praise of her qualifications, experience, and track record. After the vote, McKenna said that's what should be in the spotlight.
Each candidate for each position should be weighed entirely on their qualifications.
McKenna's nomination goes to the full Senate for a vote, which could come as soon as next week. Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.